bad baby.
With what?
This was clean and plus my hydraulics. I don't know what you did.
I replaced them.
Oh, they're all good. What you used to fix the rollerblade. Right? Just like this mechanism.
See if you can rip it off.
Seems like it's getting loose. No, but it's still have a lot to involve. Oh, you mean pull it off?
Yeah. I have to use both hands, maybe stand more right here and pull toward the camera. Wiggle it. Oh, you got it. Okay, now move, please. Another pull.
I want that pizza ball.
Cool.
I think it's just this.
And this.
Oh.
But I don't really want to take this out, personally. Maybe you can do it just like this.
What's pulling it?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, this thing right here.
You know what? I would say remove that.
Really?
Yeah.
How do you remove it?
Get the blue channel locks.
What's that?
From my bucket, the blue handled pliers. There. Now I'll use it to pinch these two parts together and then pull them toward you after it's pinched together. Pinching it together opens it and then pulling it toward you frees it up. And then maybe while you hold it, try to wiggle that part off, the hose off. You got to pull on the hose and pull it toward you.
Oh.
With your left hand. Your right hand is just keeping the clasp open. Your left hand's pulling the hose off. Wiggle it violently. It's hard. Or just slide the thing all the way down more and then pull the hose off with both hands. Maybe that's good. Maybe just try to wiggle the hose off. You gotta use all your strength. This is the part I meant when I said it's just a lot of like hard on your hands, like physically taxing. Good, you got it. Very good job. Now we can swing this. See, these have no clips. Stupid mechanic didn't put back in all the pop rivets, so I had to order a bunch. This is unacceptable. It's missing 1, 2, 3 rivets. That's these.
Oh.
They snap in and they don't come out and they hold everything in place. This one's loose though. This one's on properly. So is this one. So I realize your car is missing all of its rivets. Look at that. Boom. So now we have access. Okay. And I've got all the steps mapped out here. This is awesome. Okay. Put down towels to catch dripping brake fluid is our next move. So go get some dirty towels. No, it's not air in the system. What happens is the pistons of the brake master cylinder They fold backwards as you press the brakes, allowing the fluid to go right past them, so your brakes don't deploy at all. And your brake pedal just drops to the floor. It is not air. There is no leak, and there's no way air could have been introduced. If there was a leak, you'd have no fluid, you'd have no pressure. This is an intermittent problem where the master cylinder intermittently fails, and that's because the master cylinder internal seals have gone soft and mushy, and they flip upside down sometimes when you press the brakes. Okay, so I want you to stuff these strategically so that these two lines, if they were to drip, will not drip onto car parts. So just stuff it underneath, underneath this thing, like back in here, all back in there, just all around in all directions. Just create like a bird nest underneath the master cylinder area. Where's your gloves? Took them both off?
They broke.
Do you want the cloth ones? I want you to tap like that hard on these little nuts. All the ones I spray, that's all. The two on the left and the two in the back of that part.
With the hammer?
Yeah, just tap them. That's supposed to break free any internal rust, yeah. Do like 15 taps. It's a good hardness.
Each?
Yeah, you could hit that thing too, yeah. Might be overkill, but even the instructions for penetrating fluid says to smack it, to jar loose the rust, and then spray it again. Rinse, repeat that until you feel. I mean, the last thing I want is to strip something or break something. It keeps happening to me on these rusty cars. Tap or vibrate parts to help loosen. Reapply and repeat process until parts come free. So that's exactly what we want to do. You have to somehow tap that back nut. No, the back right. The back right one.
No, I don't see a back right. There's three of them, right?
No.
Oh,
the left one on the back right.
Did you spray that one?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, I didn't see you do it.
I don't know how you're going to tap it. Just do your best. You can do little taps. Yeah, even that says tap or vibrate. Even that will do something. Maybe you gotta hit this one more times though, since you can't get a good angle. So do like 30 times. Good job. Okay, it says to re-penetrating oil it again. Okay, can you throw this away in that garbage pile by the mailbox? And the thing you dropped. We want no problems, guys. That's why I'm going the extra mile here. It might seem like overkill, but trust me, I'm starting to learn that. I'm telling you, everything is hard to take off on this car. It's not like, oh, just turn the wrench, forehead. No. when you turn a wrench, the part breaks in half. When you turn a wrench, the wrench breaks in half. When you turn a wrench, the nut rounds off. It doesn't turn. That's my experience. Okay, drink more of Mountain Dew.
Pass me it?
Nope, you gotta go around.
Pass me?
Maybe. No skipping. No skipping.
I think I want to.
These are useless, and they're for that purpose. So that leaves us to normal wrenches. Okay, on the box, grab the normal wrenches underneath that. Those wrenches. Yeah, those might be it, yeah. Okay. It said 10 millimeter. Come around to the side so you can help work. Bring your pop, come bring it with you. Let me see if 9 fits. Hold on, don't do that. Oh, you got it?
Yeah.
You know what? I think we loosened it so much it didn't matter. Alright, what does it say? Use Crowfoot wrench, 10 millimeter to remove the two brake lines. Okay, yeah, you're removing them entirely. So just unscrew it until the whole brake line comes out.
Take it off though. It's leaking.
That's fine. You're removing it. It's going to leak.
Can they see or is my hair in the way?
Try to be more to the left. Let's see. Probably do it by hand though.
Okay.
Okay, now do the other one. The reservoir was already empty. A 3/8 ratchet with swivel that's about 14 inches long, the top one.
Here?
No, all the way, yeah. It's a silver-shaped big wrench that's about 13. No.
Oh.
No, but it has to be the bottom one. You got the 12? See if it goes on. You gotta push the button on the back. Okay. Walk around. Or run around. No skipping. No skipping.
Can you put it to the left?
I can't touch. I have dirty hands too. Just tuck in your shirt. I don't know. You can't really touch anything though. Probably want to come in from the left-hand angle. Yeah, like that. But make sure that the ratchet turns counterclockwise. So test it with your hand. Holding, holding the socket, try turning it. Is it going tight? Yeah, it's going tight. So you need to flip the angle switch to the right. That's what turns direction. Now, make sure it's going loose, lefty-loosey. Is it?
I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't understand.
That will loosen. That will loosen. So that's good. Okay, now get it on there with it angled how you had it. With your hand toward the left. Yeah, like that. You might have to pull the brake line out of the way a little bit. Might need both your other hand to guide it on. You need to move your hand more to the left to turn it. No, take it off. But you should have turned it way to the right like that. You needed to turn it toward your left.
I haven't, this way.
Yeah, but you need this handle to be out this at this angle. Yeah, like that. In fact, even more, you need the handle way out to the left. It can't be bent that far. Yeah, like that. That's your angle you want when you push down on it to turn it. Yeah, like that angle.
It's changing the angle by itself.
I know. You have to hold the tool onto the bolt with your right hand, and with your left hand set your angle and then push down. But you got to make sure it's on there real good on the bolt. Otherwise it will strip the bolt. You got to make sure it's all the way home. You got to press it against the bolt good. Make sure it goes all the way in. Yeah, it's still not all the way in. It has to go all the way until the socket is home. So you're going to need to wiggle it with your right hand. Your left hand should be holding the tool. Your right hand should be guiding the socket all the way home. You need to wiggle it.
I think it is all the way home.
Okay, then push down once you feel that way. No, it's not all the way home. I can see from here that it's not all the way home. It needs to be until it's completely flush with the back.
Here, you get bolt. It home, and then I will... Is that too big?
There, I got it home. Can you pull it toward the left?
No, that's not in the way. There.
That looks good. Yeah, that's all the way home. Is it turning? Is it turning?
Yeah.
You're getting it! Oh, baby, you're a mechanic! What a beast!
But it looks like I'm just moving it back and forth.
No, you're not. As long as you hear clicking, that means your tool is resetting without the bolt moving, but it only moves when you move your hand to the left. If it doesn't click, that means that you're making no progress, which I think is starting to happen. Oh, as long as you're clicking, you're making progress. So, yeah, you're good as long as it clicks. Every time it clicks, it's allowing the bolt to not move while the tool does move. So you are... progressing. More clicks, better. That's your audio giveaway. Alright, you need to come at it from this angle then. Got it! Man. and it's a good thing we have the swivel and the extension, all these fancy things. I never had a swivel wrench. I just bought it like, oh, that's kind of fancy. I've seen it on some car videos. I'll get a swivel wrench. And now it ends up literally being necessary for the very next job I do. Or second job I do out here again.
Darn it.
Came off?
Yeah. The other one?
No. First, I want you to get the blue channel locks. Which I have here. And use this to decouple the hose from the top of the master cylinder. You're going to grip it the same way we gripped this hose. It's the same kind, and you got to wiggle it back. Toward you, you're going to want to turn the wrench 180 degrees. Have the top tooth on the right.
Like this?
No, rotate. No, just turn it 180. Turn the wrench upside down so the right handle's facing toward me. Yeah, like that. Now it will get a better angle. And just grip it, and then you need to wiggle it and pull the whole thing toward us by an inch. Travel it along the pipe after you squeeze it all the way in. You're going to need to rotate it left and right, twisting it, and wiggle it toward us until it's off. Keep coming another half inch toward us. Keep wiggling. Good, good. Now just pull off the whole hose. It's going to take both hands wiggling. But actually, with your left hand, support the master cylinder, I think, and pull it off with your right.
Good job, baby. Okay, now Remove the whole thing.
Now, yeah, you gotta unscrew the left hand by hand and then pull the whole thing out. All right, I'll check for that.
Yeah.
Although, wouldn't it be.
Hey, baby.
What? Oh, good. If that happens, TXT, we're in big trouble.
What's that? Poison? Pulling it out.
Oh, wait. What would we do if that happened, though?
What is THT?
If the master cylinder leaked into the brake booster, we would have to replace the booster anyways, eventually. So might as well just wait till that happens. I mean, is there anything we could actually do if we saw that was going on? Just pull it out, it's fine.
I don't know if it was going to explode. You're talking like something's about to happen. Come here.
Hey, hold on. All right. I'm going to inspect it. Let's look at it. Does it look like it was leaking into the black box, he said? No, I don't think so, right? I don't see, like, fluid around.
Maybe.
We would see fluid around there. It'd be wet. You see the dry dust at the bottom? There'd be fluid everywhere if it was leaking into that thing.
Well, we have to change with gloves. Give me dry gloves.
No, I can see signs of dryness around the base of that piston at the top. It would be all wet everywhere on that white thing.
So you're saying the master cylinder was not the problem?
No, I'm saying the master cylinder wasn't leaking into this. So he was saying we might have to replace this black
thing. Oh, okay.
Master cylinder was the problem, but that thing, so we just verified the booster's okay. You changed them both together? Oh my gosh.
You're supposed to change them both together?
Well, no. As a mechanic, they would change them both because it'd be cheaper if it's already all out exposed for the customer rather than coming back. but we're not worried about price, so we would, if the booster failed next, we would have to do this whole job again to get at the booster.
Oh my gosh.
Which isn't necessarily going to happen.
Yeah.
Booster might last for 10 years.
Man.
So, okay. Let me read the next thing.
Shit.
A new master cylinder.
Now I know.
All right, which is here.
Now I know why mechanics charge so much. Now I have pity.
Actually, before you put it on, do you have any brake fluid on your fingers?
Yeah.
Okay, wipe it around that and around just everywhere.
Here?
Yeah. And then around just the metal face. Okay. No, I'm serious. You're supposed to. Okay, so we just rubbed a little bit of brake fluid around this and around that. I don't know if you have to with this type or not.
I didn't.
No, that's good enough.
I didn't touch this one.
Okay, that's good enough. All right, now let's light it on.
Wait, hold on. Okay.
You got it?
Yeah.
All right, here's the two nuts you got to put back on. There's one at a time. Just wiggle it hand tight on the left side first.
On the left side?
Yeah. We're doing the opposite order of what we just did. So that was the last thing we took off. Just put it on like till it's halfway. Or actually until your fingers can't turn anymore. Just keep going all the way hand tight. Way up, and it's going to be very weird. Well, that's a good angle.
Why are you laughing?
You're positioning. I should be using the pad. Why don't you use the pad
to laugh? Oh, sorry guys, my hair is all up in the video. Oh. Move my hair. There you go. Okay. Now what?
You got it hand tight on the right side?
Yeah.
Good job. Okay, now you got to wrestle that. Oh my gosh. Remove that yellow cap first from the master cylinder top part.
Hey.
Alright, hand it to me. Good. Okay, now put the hose back over the part the yellow thing was on. It's going to be hard. You're going to have to wiggle it violently. The tool won't help. You got to use your hands and just, you got to press it and just, it's going to be super hard to get on. You got it?
No.
Oh, I was about to say that was fast.
Okay, I got it.
What? Muscle woman. Good job.
No, I have to tell you something.
Okay, then use the blue channel locks to squeeze the metal part and wiggle it until it closes over the end of the hose. And you should see an impression where it used to sit before. So wiggle it until it lands on that impression. We're not going to bench plate it now. What we're going to do is the Scotty Kilmer method, which is you turn the two brake hoses on like four turns. You depress the brake pedal, and if it only four turns, it will hiss air. And then you tighten it all the way. Then you release the brakes. And then you loosen it up all the way until it's four turns again. And then you press the brakes and it will hiss air. And you rinse repeat that until it starts hissing oil. which meant they're completely blood. And then we'll bleed all four lines after that.
I don't know why I'm being so challenged with this. Like, why am I being challenged? I'm not doing this right?
Yeah, turn the right, or the left handle to the right and the right handle to the left. That's how you had it before.
Like,
yeah, like
this?
That, like that. Yep, now wiggle. Yep, and completely pull. It's where it used to be. Does it look like it matches? Further or less far? You'll see the impressions of where it used to sit. No, it's not all the way up.
Kind of seems like it's all the way, actually. Check that one out. Sweetheart.
Can't see. Perfect. Okay, great job. You're doing it. All right, now put in the both brake hoses.
Here.
And turn them
Wait, do I have to? I have to remove these things, don't I?
Oh yeah.
Right?
Yeah. I'll take them.
Okay.
All right. Now.
I should probably tighten it first before putting them all in, the way in, right?
Did you just put them in without tightening so far?
Yeah.
All right. You're only going to tighten it four turns. We want it to leak. So only four turns.
No, I'm talking about the back ones.
Oh, yeah. Those need to be all the way tightened.
Yeah, I got before I do these,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, do that first. All right.
How am I tightening? Oh my gosh, am I doing the socket wrench again?
Yeah, that's probably the best way.
Okay, you want to pass me it? Socket wrench! I feel like I'm doing surgery. This is going to be tough. I used to love socket wrenches.
No?
No. Anymore.
What was wrong with the real long extension you said?
This was in the way.
That?
Yeah.
Did we take that off?
That would be awesome.
Is it?
It's right here.
We...
I don't know. There's like a lot of stuff coming out of it. Mm. Is this right?
Oh, you want the long extension for it? Maybe? It might be easier.
Yeah. Take this one off.
Just pull hard. Wait, actually, I wasn't sure. I said yeah too soon. I couldn't be wrong. Isn't it insane how hard to access this is? It's like so in there.
There we go. Beautiful. Beautiful!
Yeah, it's turning. Everything's good.
Ow!
Should we just put on the one bolt and leave the right one off?
No.
It's not.
Wow,
easy.
Yeah.
That's good enough.
Yeah, that's what mechanics say, and then you get mad.
As long as we do it extra tight, right?
Yeah, that's what mechanics say, and that's what, and you're like, oh, I hate mechanics. So I was taking shortcuts, yet you're doing the same thing. Hey, probably doesn't have to be that tight, right? Maybe. That's messed up. And I was like, what the heck? Doesn't have to be that tight, right, baby?
No, it does. I mean, well, no, not until we do the other side, probably. We'll do one more turn on this after we do the other side. All right,
Okay. See, it's hard to go.
The whole metal part.
Ow, ow, here. Oh, he just.
You gotta take that out. Take the tool
Oh, now it's stuck. Okay, there we go.
Get it on, and then I'll let go.
I think it is on. Doesn't it look on?
Yeah, it's on.
It's not turning.
Yeah, it is. As long as that clicks, it means it's turning. I would swing your hand out more to the left when you want to go tight, at least. Support it with your right hand so it stays in line. Move your right hand forward. Yeah, now lift. That's a better angle. As long as we keep hearing a click, it means we're still getting it tighter.
Yeah, like a little click.
That's okay. One click means it went a little tighter.
How am I gonna know exact turn?
One, two. Three. You're doing long turns.
That's why I don't know how much.
Back it out a half turn. Okay, stop. Not all the way out.
I want to start over. You're gonna tell
okay.
me.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay. We have to fill the brake fluid now. Wow.
Wait, we haven't turned it all.
No, they said to. Right now, though.
Booyah.
We literally changed a master cylinder. That's
boo
insane.
To the yeah.
That's advanced. That's not.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So, I need a funnel, I think. Yeah.
And how
Unless
come
if that's just a stain.
How come it switched, it filled all the way to the top though?
No, that's just because it's slow to go through the filter.
Oh.
You're filling the master cylinder right now and the whole pipe and the bottom of that, so that's why it's going to take a while before we see it in this. This is like the
Where did
overfill.
You put it? How come it's not going through?
It doesn't. You just
Oh.
hold it. I just did that so we wouldn't spill. It's gonna take a while. You can go a little more than that until you see it.
It's leaking through.
Oh, it's starting to come up. That's fine. Just keep filling.
Oh, I'm starting to see it now.
All right, twist it a little more so it's not leaking out like that.
Here.
Okay, and the other side too. It's okay if it drips occasionally. That's like crazy a lot. Alright, not too much though. The point of this is I'm going to go in the car and I'm going to press the brakes and it should pump air out and some fluid.
Wait, should I fill this to the max?
No, it's fine. That's irrelevant. That's just overflow. Alright, so I'm going to hold the... Well, first you need the tool to tighten it. You're going to tighten them all the way after I press the brakes down. Okay, so here's the tool.
Oh, okay. Here. Okay, which side?
I'm going to press the brakes down, then you're going to tighten both lines all the way.
I'm not too heavy for this, am I?
So, as soon as I press, I'll say tighten them.
Oh my gosh.
What's happening?
A lot of it was coming out. Oh, I can't do more, but there's a lot.
Are I can't
tighten it more.
It's all the way?
I can't tighten it more.
What I mean is, did you tighten it so you feel it's tight?
Yeah, but there's more to give. Maybe there's just a lot more to go in. Baby, there's like a ton of the line.
Do you recall if there's thread showing or not before?
No. Okay, well then, I think it's good.
Both of them?
You can try it yourself.
All right, then you have to come here and hold the gas pedal down.
The gas pedal or the brake? The
brake pedal. Hold it with your hand like that. Yeah, hold it. Hold it both hands. Keep it held. Yeah. That was real good, baby. It's okay that threads are showing. Now you can let go. Yeah. All right. All right, now loosen brake hoses all the way again, and then turn them four turns so they're loose again. Yeah, we have to do this over and over. Each time when it's loose and we press the brakes down, air is going to escape.
So why did I tighten so much?
So that when we let the brakes up, it doesn't suck air in.
Okay, so what am I doing right now?
We only want air to come out when I'm pressing down on the brakes. We don't want air to enter when I let go of the brakes. Does that make sense?
What am I doing now?
You're loosening, you're taking them all the way off and then four turns like before. Or actually, I think we did like six turns. I think four was too much.
Oh my goodness.
I mean, four was not enough. I mean, because so much fluid was coming out, you said.
I can't.
How are we doing on fluid levels in the overflow reservoir? Is it still pretty high?
Yeah, I think so. Oh!
Is the cheater bar to loosen it?
They can't loosen it with this. It doesn't even like, it's like no space for it. It's too fat. Ay, Dios mío. Yeah, I don't even know how this works. All the way out? Where'd you go? All the way?
Yeah, well, not all the way, just so it's loose and maybe dripping a couple times.
Like that?
Yeah. Yeah, good.
Okay, let me get the other one. Ay, Dios mío. Okay.
Bends off transmission case pressure. Without that, it would push fluid past the seals in the transmission. They don't have to be super tight snug because you're going to loosen them again. Oh, they don't have to be all the way in either. Loosen them four turns is what he means, not all the way loose and then threaded four turns. Oh, I didn't mean that, but that's probably right. Okay, so as long as they're dripping, that's fine.
They're dripping pretty a lot.
All right, I'm going to press the solution around the air coming out. I'm going to hold it, and you're going to tighten them again. So, tighten, start tightening now.
It doesn't have to be super tight, right?
No. Super tight by hand, but if you use the cheater bar, then just very much. Well, by hand, you're not going
Okay,
you know if it's worse when you drive your car tonight?
Really?
I'm not kidding. It's the only dangerous thing about your car.
Okay, I think it's good.
Both?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm letting go. Okay. Now, loosen them up.
Loosen them up?
Yep.
Now? Could you, hold on. Huh? Oh, okay. Okay. Oh. Ugh, tools are so deceiving. Because I'm like, oh, it's easily turning. And so I want to use my finger, and then it's a lie. Okay, you said kind of almost all the way? I think so. Okay, I think it's good.
Okay, when the press breaks down, some fluid and air is going to come out and you're going to tighten them. So, start. Okay, now tighten them.
How many more times do we have to do this? 10 more times? Shoot, we're switching off.
No, we're not.
Yeah, we are.
No, we're not.
Okay, it's pretty tight. Back on.
Both on?
Yeah.
Okay, now loosen. Actually, it might be like 4 or 5 times. How many do you think?
I don't know.
You didn't actually say it. It probably depends on the car. It depends on how loose you're making it. There's a lot of factors we don't know.
Okay. Ooh, they're leaking a lot. No. Yeah. It's close to minimum. How does so pretty much two mechanics have to work on this job?
Oh, there's a crate where you put a piece of wood between the front seat and the brakes. You can use your electronic body to press the brakes down with the wood being instead of your foot, and then you do the tightening while it's held down by the wood or a pipe.
Oh, yeah.
Even with the non-electronic seat, you can do it. You just wedge a pipe between the seat and the brake.
Okay, it's tight.
Alright, let it go. Alright, now loosen. So basically, you can use a pipe or a screwdriver or something wedged between the seat and the brake to hold it while you do it. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And if you have a partner, it's that much easier.
We have to leave, sweetheart. No, we gotta go. Oh, hold on, baby. Okay.
Loose.
Loose.
Monica?
Yeah.
That's a good sign. I mean, we're probably done, but we're just doing extra to be safe.
Yeah, I'm gonna hurry up though. Feels like a bug's on my back. Maybe it's my hair. Okay. Okay, it should be tight. Loosen? Oh my gosh, my hands are getting sore. Okay. Tighten. Yeah.
More than ever or about the same length?
I think about the same.
I felt very stiff that time for some reason. I actually have all the air out.
So what should we do? One more? Okay. Yeah. No, they're loose. That was a lot. A lot came out. No, it's like below min. I think we're good, baby. Okay.
One full bleed, and then it's done. Done. We have to bleed every wheel, which is another 2 or 3 hours of work. But that's what I was planning to do tomorrow anyways. I just thought, Scotty Kilmer didn't mention doing this, so I thought maybe you don't have to. All right, so that's all put away.